Hello, welcome back to Call Clutter Fairy, where I help you get clutter-free so that you can live stress-free. Today, we're going into part two of setting up files. If you've watched the first part of this, we've already broken down how to establish your categories and how to approach them from a high level and then funnel down that categorization so that you have a very simplistic system. So hopefully you've already watched that and have your systems broken down, but if you haven't, I suggest that you go ahead and watch part one first. But once you have the categories broken down and you have things set up, what do you do with these files? How do you maintain them so that you don't have to do this again? That's what we're going to talk about today. There are a couple of really inexpensive and easy ways that you can set up these files. One of the easiest ones is getting an inexpensive binder. This effectively becomes one single category, and you can set these on a shelf. One can just be taxes, another can be bills, another one can be your automotive. You can color code these if you want by just slipping in a piece of paper of a spine, or you can keep it really simple looking by just having the name in it. I know a lot of people with their files, it's very beneficial for them to have a visualization of different colors. So this is really a preference of what works best for you. The nice thing about having a binder like this is you can treat it just like you would a file drawer. So let's just call this category cars, for example. So this would just say automotive. And inside this binder, you would have everything for each individual family car, for insurances, maintenance, and any roadside assistance that you have. That can all be broken down here. And all you need to do is get the file insert tabs to break up the categories. Another benefit to having them in binders like this, you can either have it on a shelf or you can file it in a drawer still. This allows for a maximized storage capacity, but it's super easy to just pull out a binder. In this case, we're going to keep using automotive as an example. Open it up to your Toyota. And within that Toyota, you can see that all of the maintenance together. You can flip to this next section under your Toyota and see all of the DMV paperwork. You can switch to the next section and see your AAA membership. It's all together, and after you add the new piece of paper, you could just put it right back into the file drawer or on a shelf. The system that I use most often is I have these hanging file folders, and I just bought all of the same color. Now, again, if color coding is what helps you, by all means, I always say make sure you're doing this in a way that works best for you. I am a very streamlined person, so I like the least amount of distractions as I can. So when I look into a file drawer, all of the different colors, it's very hard for me to focus on which thing am I looking for, but I know for a fact I have certain clients who color coding is the difference between a successful system and a chaotic system. So whatever works best for you. But I bought all of the same color, and I bought a pack of 100 because I knew I only had about 50 files, and I wanted to make sure I had plenty of extras so that as I added files, they were the same color. I know a lot of times when I go to reorder something, it's a slightly different shade. And for me personally, I'm a little OCD. It drives me crazy to have different shades of the regular green or the gray. So if that's a problem for you, buy extra at the same time so you get the same dye lot and the same hue. The next thing I do, oftentimes if it's just one thing, for example, with my business, I have leads, and I have the leads broken down by those that were actually hired or those that didn't end up going to a contract. So I just keep those loose inside of the hanging file folder, and I just have those chronologically organized. But there's other times when I'll have one or two things within a category, and I'll just set up a file folder for that. So again, going to automotive, there would be a tab right here that says automotive, and then I would have a file folder for each thing saying the Toyota. I would have another one for DMV. I would have another one for insurance. And just within this little section would be my automotive. I know this is hard to describe, so let me show you some examples. So this first example that I have here, the very first section is yellow. That's the color I designated for this client for auto. As you can see, I wanted to keep it simple for the client so that if they added any files, it is not difficult for them to have to replicate. So as long as they are setting up right-sided file folders, they can just place one of these yellow file labels onto it and just keep adding. It's a simple, simple system. But you can see we have the tab at the front that says auto. So super easy to maintain. Once they know they have something that goes with the car, they can just go to the auto section, find the vehicle or find the insurance policy, and just add into it or take out what they need. You can see behind auto is a blue section, and we set this up for credit card information. So my client now knows that the blue section is all credit cards. And the beauty with this is, you know, sometimes we're not very diligent, we'll pull something out, when we put it back, it could be misfiled. But if they drop this blue file anywhere else, it's going to stick out like a sore thumb. They can't help but notice, wait a minute, that's in the wrong place. So as long as it's within the blue, even if it's not alphabetized, it's a small section to go through and find that file that you're looking for. An extra step that we took when we did set up this specific client was within each section, we said auto the car, auto dash insurance, auto dash DMV. And again, this just really simplifies so that if you're looking for something, there is no doubt, especially if you get into a situation where you have to duplicate colors, by putting the category first, the name of it on the file label, and then naming that specific category underneath auto, you'll never lose anything. And it is undoubtedly clear when you go to file something exactly where that paper goes. The last section in this particular example is red, and this had everything to do with their actual finances. So we wanted to make sure that this was a separate color, but once again, separate placement. So when you're looking at this, it's so super easy to see which files. Personally, I think this type of file system where they're all chaotic and everywhere is very difficult, and there's so much visual clutter that it's difficult to navigate and find something quickly. Having something this streamlined just makes it super, super easy to quickly see a file that you're looking for, and this helps you to put the paperwork away so much more easily. On this particular one, we opted to not do the staggered tabs. The client liked it much more streamlined, so we went just with the colors. But again, we did those tabs so that it says the category, dash, and then subcategory. So once again, if the client accidentally drops a file in the wrong space, first of all, the color is going to stand out, but also the tab is going to say which category it should belong to, so it can go right back into its proper place. This type of very simplistic, streamlined setup, I promise, will make it so easy when you get a paper to know exactly where it should go. Now, the key, of course, to staying on top of your files is purging the things that you do not need. I have a download here in the link in the description below where I have outlined how long you should archive your paperwork. I always recommend double checking with your tax professional first, but the average is 7 to 10 years for tax information, so you don't need to keep anything longer than that. But make sure to click in the description below, find that link, and download the archival cheat sheet for you so that you know exactly how long the recommended time to keep documents are. I wanted to bring this up one more time. I am not sponsored, nor am I being endorsed in any way from Freedom Filer. I have just found it really is a great system. So I wanted to mention that one more time. If looking at all of this paperwork is just too difficult, and I understand it could be overwhelming, then Freedom Filer might be a wonderful solution for you as it completely breaks down all of the categories for you. You just need to match up the paperwork to that pre-existing category and then slide the pre-done tab inside of the plastic holder, and your files are set up. I'm hoping that this video helped you get your paperwork under control. I know I've said this before, but truly just taking that 15 minutes a day and taking little bites at it. It will feel like forever, but I assure you, you can get it done. I've had mounds of paperwork that I've done for clients, and if you just keep looking at what is it, not necessarily what you have to do with it, it really does help break it down. I did have a subscriber mention that it would be difficult for them if they just took all of their paperwork and piled it together because of the action items, and yes, I forgot. I apologize for not saying that before. If you have important papers that you know you need to act upon, yes, please don't just throw those into a box and have them lost while you're sorting through. Keep those important papers out where you can access them. If you have a doctor's appointment and that paperwork is telling you where to go and what lab results you need, keep it where you can find it. But if you have a lot of papers that have just been lying around and they've been there for a little while, those are the papers that are okay to put into a big pile and take one little 15-minute session at a time until they are set up. Please leave me a comment below if this helped you. If you're struggling with it at all, I welcome your comments and questions. I will get to all of them and see what suggestions that I can make. I always appreciate your feedback and your views, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.